While automakers have been busy cramming turbo and plug-in hybrid powertrains into more models and planning for an electric future, the full-size SUV class moves on with bigger belt lines and more internal combustion powertrain options. Large SUVs provide room for up to 9 people, plus they have towing, hauling, and off-road capability above and beyond what you can get in a midsize SUV. Also known as full-size SUVs, these vehicles have truck base, body-on-frame, platforms. Which is the right model for you? Take a look at this list of the 6 highest-rated large SUVs. The Toyota Land Cruiser does not feature in this list, since it was discontinued in the US market following the 2021 model year. Number 6. Toyota Sequoia. Largely unchanged for 2021, the Toyota Sequoia's thrust comes from a 5.7-liter V8, making 381 horsepower and an archaic but proven 6-speed automatic transmission. Rear-wheel drive is standard, while 4-wheel drive is our recommended option. The Sequoia is available in 6 different trim levels, ranging in price from $50,000 for the SR5 all the way up to $66,000 for the tricked-out Platinum model. In our opinion, a well-optioned SR5 is the smartest buy. Towing is rated at 7,400 pounds, and a third row of seats allows the Sequoia to fit up to 8 passengers. The interior is relatively sparse and does nothing to hide the truck's 15-year-old design. Still, basic amenities such as Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, as well as Wi-Fi hotspot capability, are available. Fun facts: Toyota Sequoia was originally going to be named the Highlander, which became the name for Toyota's crossover vehicle. 2002 was Sequoia's highest sales year, with 70,187 units sold. Number 5. Ford Expedition and Expedition Max. With great space for up to 8 and 9,300 pounds of towing capacity, the thoroughly modern Ford Expedition is a great SUV for family adventures. 0 to 60 miles per hour in 5.9 seconds is mighty quick for a 3-ton sled that can carry up to 8 passengers. But if the 2021 Ford Expedition Max, along with the standard Expedition, wants to succeed at dethroning GM from its title as king of the full-size SUV heap, it better have some game. Power comes from a twin-turbocharged 3.5-liter V6 that makes 375 or 400 horsepower, depending on trim. A base model Expedition, which comes with only 2 rows of seating and standard rear-wheel drive, starts at $51,000. A long-wheelbase Expedition Max Platinum, however, rang in at $84,000, a price that makes a lot of European luxury competition look quite appealing. Interesting fact: a power-tilting and telescoping steering column isn't necessary headline news, but the Expedition's adjustment button has a simple design that makes adjusting the position of the steering wheel effortless. The adjustment button is also ideally located on the left side of the steering column and is not difficult to find. Thanks, Ford! Number 4. Nissan Armada. Reshaped sheet metal and a spruced-up interior carry the already impressive Nissan Armada into 2021. It has room for 8 and a tow rating of 8,500 pounds. The upper trims move it toward infinity levels of luxury. Power is supplied by a tried-and-true 400-horsepower 5.6-liter V8, which, when fed premium fuel, makes 10 more horsepower and 19 more pound-foot of torque than last year's model. Inside, a new 12.3-inch infotainment display is now standard, and offers Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and the ability to set up a Wi-Fi hotspot. There's also a new entry-level S trim that has a base price of $50,000. Additionally, every 2021 Armada comes with a slew of new safety features, including forward collision warning, adaptive cruise control, blind spot warning, and driver attention alert. Number 3. Chevrolet Suburban. The Chevy Suburban is one of the largest SUVs available. All new for 2021, it's roomier, has fresh safety and tech, and the option of a diesel engine. It's longer and more stylish than ever, and it was born in 1934. The 2021 model sees a redesign for the big bruiser, and while its aesthetics have changed, its aura has not. Though the new Suburban is still available with one of 2 V8 gas engines, making either 355 or 420 horsepower, there's now a torquey turbo diesel option that can be fitted as well. Chevy replaced the old solid rear axle with an independent suspension setup to improve on-road handling and increase the size of its third-row seat and cargo area. Price starts at $53,000 for an LS model, although our favorite is the mid-pack RST trim, which can be fitted with the diesel engine as well as four-wheel drive. Interesting facts. Oldest in the West, entering its eighth decade of production, the Chevrolet Suburban is the longest continuously running nameplate in the U.S. auto industry, first produced in 1935. Small price, $675. That's how much a brand spanking new Suburban cost off the production line in 1935. However, it didn't include high-end options like a rear bumper or heating. Number 2. Chevrolet Tahoe. Like the Suburban, the 2021 Tahoe has been redesigned to offer fresh looks and a range of new features. Chief among them are a turbo diesel engine, which makes 460 pound-foot of torque, and a new independent rear suspension. There are six different trim levels to be had, with pricing ranging from $50,295 for an LS to $70,895 for the plush High Country model. A 10-speed automatic transmission is standard, and while four-wheel drive is optional, rear-wheel drive is standard. Interior space has also increased all around, including in the cargo area and for adults forced to sit in the third row. Those looking to wander off paved roads may be interested in the Z71 model, which comes out of the box with four-wheel drive, a 2-speed transfer case, and a front skid plate. Number 1. GMC Yukon and Yukon XL. If the Tahoe or Suburban's new design language is a little too loud for you, take a look at the Yukon or Yukon XL. The 2021 GMC Yukon and long wheelbase Yukon XL are completely remade, with more room, more features, and more muscle. Functionally the same, the GMCs offer a sleek design along with attractive option packages. Our favorite is the SLT, which includes 20-inch wheels, heated and ventilated leather seats, and a power rear liftgate. As with the Chevrolets, the Yukon and extended wheelbase Yukon XL have three different engine options available, including a 5.3-liter or 6.2-liter V8, or a torque-tastic 3.0-liter turbo diesel inline 6. All models are equipped with a 10.2-inch infotainment display, while a heads-up display is available on the AT4 trim and standard on the top-spec Denali. All models offer a variety of standard driver assistant features, such as park assist, automatic high beam control, lane keep assist, and forward collision alert. Fun fact, the Yukon's hurricane turn feature. It's understood that hurricane turn is enabled when the Yukon's ECU detects the driver has deactivated the stability control system, cranked the steering wheel hard to left or right, and floored the accelerator. If these actions are made and the SUV is on a low friction surface, the brakes on the side you're steering towards will be enabled and the outer wheels will spin. If the driver keeps the throttle pinned, the 2021 GMC Yukon will gradually spin in a tighter and tighter circle until it's nearly spinning around its central axis. Large SUVs are bigger than mid-sized sports utility vehicles and come standard with three rows of seats. If you're trying to choose between a large and a mid-sized SUV, consider how you want to use the vehicle. If you want more towing capability and genuine off-road prowess, consider a large full-size SUV. These are based on rugged truck foundations, which contributes to their capability, but fuel economy often suffers because of these vehicles' size and weight. Thanks for stopping by. Before you go, I hope you liked this video. Please consider subscribing and turning on the bell button for more automotive-related content if you haven't done so yet. Stay tuned.